Hello everyone, my topic for November submission is Mountain Railways of India, Management of Tangible Rural Heritage. Our heritage is the shared wealth of mankind. Preserving such valuable assets demand our collective efforts. India is wealthy of such heritages. Apart from our rich connections with past culture, monuments and buildings, India's heritage railways tell us a lot about our nation and its history. They have added to our country's glamour quotient and draws tourists from across the world. Such rails, time and again, seek to recreate scenes of the past. Mountain railways of India are the best examples of bold, ingenious engineering solution for the problem of establishing an effective rail link through rugged, mountainous and terrain. This is the only reason the Darjeeling Himalayan Railway, the Nilgiri Mountain Railway and the Kalka-Shimla Railway are designated as a UNESCO World Heritage Site. So, coming on to the brief introduction, the Mountain Railway of India consists of three railways, which consist of the Darjeeling Himalayan Railway, located in the foothills of the Himalayas in West Bengal, having an area of 5.334 hectare. Nilgiri Mountain Railway is located in the Nilgiri Hills of Tamil Nadu, South India, and Kalka-Shimla Railway located in the Himalayan foothills of Himachal Pradesh, Northwest India. All three railways are still fully functional and operational. The Mountain Railways of India are outstanding example of hill railways opened between 1881 and 1908. They applied bold and ingenious engineering solutions to the problem of establishing an effective rail link across a mountainous terrain of great beauty. They are still fully operational as living example of the engineering enterprises of the late 19th and early 20th century. As said by the World Heritage Center, UNESCO, the railways are an outstanding example of rural transportation system which comes under certain criteria 2 and criteria 4, which explains about the significance and the economic development of the respective regions. So, this is the route map of the Kalka-Shimla Railway, and if we see, so the map shows the route along the whole between Kalka and Shimla with several stoppages, and the owner of the three properties is the Railway Ministry of the Indian Government. All the laws of the Indian Union relating to railways apply to the property. In particular, the Railway Act for Technical Protection measures the Public Premises Act, which 1971, which in particular provides the right to expel unauthorized occupants. The legal protection in place is inappropriate, and Ministry of Railways is making efforts to apply the legal provision against unauthorized occupation of land within the boundaries, properties as well as the buffer zone. So management is guaranteed by the Ministry of Railways and the relevant branch offices. This is a property management plan which deals with the management of the land, the building, the track, the bridges and the tunnels for two of the three lines, that is Nilgiri and Kalka-Shimla. However, recommendations have been made to strengthen these in relation to architectural features and encroachment on the property boundaries. The resources are provided by the Indian Ministry of Railways. Train services, station facilities, platforms, passenger amenities are provided for visitors and commuters. In addition, special tourist trains are promoted. The professional personnel of the three railways, the technical assistance departments of Indian Railway are fully operational and are well prepared for climatic and geological risk. Over a century of operation, they have always managed to restore the integrity of the line. They generally intervene within a short lead time, which contributes to the monitoring of the state of conservation of the property. The three railways have the technical document necessary for the maintenance of track, infrastructure, rolling stock and station. Indian Railways has a central research department that considers climatic and geological effects with an impact on mountain lines, RDSO. It recommends protective action, particularly to prevent landslides. So, this is the map you see on the screen, that is of the Darjeeling Himalayan Railway. And it is also being extracted from the World Heritage Center UNESCO website, and was The plan was made to show the three, these plans were made to show the three mountain railways have been in service contract from its inception. They are in a good state of general conservation and maintained on a regular and permanent basis. The ensure the traditional arrangements of track maintenance by railway personnel are considered satisfactory to ensure the present and future conservation of the line. Both the Nilgiri and Kalka Shimla Railway lines have management plans which outline the process and practices that ensure the ongoing conservation of the lines and their conservation values. However, the first of the lines to be listed, that is Darjeeling Railway, still does not have an endorsed conservation management plan. In addition, the architectural management of the Kalka Shimla Railway Station buildings and the annex to ensure the aspects of the property outstanding universal value has not been sufficiently taken into account, and a medium term project should be drawn up for this purpose. The management authority should step up control of encroachment on land in the nominated property zone and in the buffer zone. In regard to the Nilgiri Kalka Shimla railways, the management plan should be substantially improved in the terms of architectural conservation and condition monitoring, and by involving the territorial authorities, particularly in relation to visitor management, to ensure that OUV are protected. So this map is of the Nilgiri Mountain Railway, and it shows the basic route plan and the whole figures and the milestones distance between the two places. So these railways are a historic holy trinity for train aficionados, but they are more than dusty relics of an empire. All three are still fully operational today, and a ride on any of them reveals the incredible engineering achievement that brought rail service to these rugged locales. The railways face intermittent problems due to political unrest in some regions. They are also at the mercy of seasonal storms, which can wash out tracks and roads and necessitate extensive repairs. So, maintaining of this treasure can be difficult and expensive, but their high appeal to tourists helps to keep them running. Thank you so much, and please share and watch the whole video.